this. I am the Taskmaster, and this is Taskmaster. It's been said that nothing in life that's worth having is easy. And yet, I find it takes no effort to get ready for this, and I am one hot tamale. Let's watch our less fortunate guests work for little reward. They are Ardal O'Hanlon, Bridget Christie, Chris Ramsey, Judi. And next to me, a man whose only facial expression is that of a baffled hare. It's little Alex Horn!
Chat time?
Yeah, I'm going to tell you some things about me, a couple of facts, and I think they're also jokes.
OK.
I support Liverpool Football Club. Mm. Yeah, I'm a die-hard fan. So there we go. I like both Liverpool and the movie Die Hard. And the other one, here are some things I don't like. Omelettes or kids. So that's it, just omelettes or children.
Anyway, prize task time.
Yes, you bet your bloody life it is, Greg. And this time they've been asked to bring in the most calming item. So chill right now. The most calming item will get its owner 5 points, and at the end of the show, the overall winner will take home 5 calming items and become all relaxed and floppy.
Bridget.
Hello.
What makes you relaxed and floppy?
I've brought in a cat cafe voucher.
Here's the voucher.
Dogs and cats are used to help people with post-traumatic stress disorder. Mm-hmm. I heard a war surgeon talking on Desert Island Discs explaining...
Keep it light.
He went to meet the Queen and she said, I can help you. She called the corgis and got him to stroke them and he was absolutely fine.
Make a point.
No, I haven't finished yet. Hang on, because I know what you're going to say. But it's not a cat, it was a dog. Anyway...
Well, I've been to a cat cafe and it didn't relax me. It's probably my own fault for bringing my pet budgie and my pet goldfish with me.
Right, I'm going to move on. Judi, what thing have you brought in that make me relaxed and floppy?
I brought a lovely fish water fountain.
Here it is.
It looks pretty stressful for the fish.
I mean, the fish aren't real.
No, it's relaxing. And you can lie at night time and listen to the water trickling along.
Could you try and recreate the sounds that you would hear? Oh, the fish are gargling, are they?
Yes.
It makes me more relaxed than the idea of a war vet stroking one of the Queen's corgis.
Two down, Greg.
Ardal.
I brought in a tea towel.
Woo!
Here is the tea towel.
Instantly calming.
Well, here's the thing. I sort of do find tea towels quite calming, but why do you find it calming?
Well, it's like a little comfy blankie. It's also great if you want to make a baby laugh, which is very relaxing. As we all know, the sound of baby's laughter is probably the most beautiful sound known to human people.
It is nice.
And all you need is a tea towel and a baby, obviously. But... you know. And it works brilliantly every time.
Chris.
I have brought an aquarium.
Ooh.
Here it's the aquarium from Chris.
So this is just a visual representation of the aquarium, but the one I'm offering you is the one from my home, which is 64 litres.
That's...
Give me some stats.
That's thank you. 64 litres, I think it's 30-odd fish points.
Fish points?
Certain size aquariums have got certain size points. Certain amount of points, and each fish is worth a couple of points.
What'll do it for me, because you did a very nice impression of yours, perhaps Chris could reproduce the sound that his make. Right, good, stop. Just imagine Bridget's... All right, good. Sophie, hello.
Hello.
Can you give something that's actually relaxing?
I brought an Access All Areas massager.
And here it is.
Yeah. Oh. It's a personal massager.
I know what
I've
it
named...
is.
Okay. And I just think, like, muscles get tired. People get het up. Sometimes you need vibrations for your back, for your cheek, or anywhere else you can think of.
Right, well, there we go. We've seen all five.
OK. Forgive me, Bridget. The cat cafe, I did not find in any way relaxing.
OK, so 1 point to Bridget.
Secondly, Judy's rubbish plastic fish fountain.
OK, 2 points to you, Judy.
I'm going to give the sex aid 3 points.
I think you should ask the women in here if they would find it relaxing.
Yes.
I'm as surprised as you that I found a dildo less relaxing than a tea towel. surprised as you. Because I haven't seen Chris's fish tank. I have to take his word that it's relaxing, and he's getting 4 points just on his description. But I am actually going to give a tea towel 5 points. And that's an end to it.
OK, 5 points to Ardal.
We're done. Let's get the first task started, please, Alex.
OK, then, Greg, and we're off to the Taskmaster house, where things are not as cement to be. Want it to stop?
No.
Right.
Use the cement mixer for something other than mixing cement.
Best use of a cement mixer other than mixing cement wins.
Your time starts when Alex does an impression of you.
I'm Chris Ramsey.
Time hasn't started yet, then.
I'm afraid it has. Where are you from?
Gloucester.
Taskmaster.
Are you joking?
Hi, babes.
OK, well, that is so me.
I haven't thought about this one. Oh, thanks a million. Okay. And we're off.
OK, right.
I'm furious.
Are you?
Yeah.
Why?
Because you're not doing an impression of me.
I'm going to do an impression of you.
OK, but you're finding it really hard.
Yes.
Pretend you went to, like, an all-girls school.
Ah, I can do this. Hello! Pardon?
Wow. OK, so you, like, go to play, like, lacrosse.
OK, give me a lacrosse stick.
Do you know how to play lacrosse?
Yes.
OK.
I'm Sophie Duca.
Should we give you a second chance with your Sophie impression?
No, I don't think so.
I mean, it was pathetic.
Yes. Yeah. Well, I can't do impressions.
You did everyone
you did,
else.
You did four impressions.
Did everyone else fight, and they all knew it was them. And then when it came to Sophie, you went, hello.
I'm a girl.
Yeah. Speak a little bit so we can have another go.
OK. Yeah, okay. This is me. Ooh.
Ooh.
Ooh. Yeah, this is me speaking.
Yeah, this is me speaking. I can't do impressions. I can't do it.
It's quite here in the voice.
Quite nasal?
Yeah.
Is this a compliment?
Hello.
I think we should get on.
Let's get on. Okay.
Get on.
Let's start with two very different approaches from two very similar people. It's Ardal and Judi. Here we go.
So, this is my salon. You've been to the hairdresser. They wash your hair. They don't do a good job. They leave shampoo in it. And I feel that this will give everything a really, really good churn. I think it will thoroughly clean the hair.
I'd like a drink, please.
You want some juice of love? Love juice?
Yes, please.
OK, OK.
I mean, ideally, you would have the cement mixer plumbed.
Plumbed.
But we didn't really have time to do that, so we're going to do it the old-fashioned way. So, Linda, if you don't mind, I'm going to... Yeah, just... Get that a bit closer.
Oh, she's in.
She's in.
It's a lovely atmosphere in the love bar.
What?
It's a lovely atmosphere.
Yeah.
I'm just going to shampoo it with the best shampoo I could find.
And is Linda's happy, is she?
She is happy, yeah, yeah.
This is what gives it that love juice, because it's got my nails in it.
Yeah.
Cherry on the side.
Lovely.
Come on out, Linda. Here we go. Okay. This is all part of the plan. So air reunited with Linda.
There you go, babes.
Well, thank you very much.
Yeah.
How much do I owe you?
17 quid each.
£34?
Yeah. Like a normal London bar, babes.
So now I'm just going to put a tiny collar in it.
Oh, lovely. Okay.
There we go.
Well, I think we could deal with Judy's quite quickly. She tossed a few drinks into a cement mixer, poured it out, and made you drink it. How was it?
Disgusting.
That's not what you
said. No, because you were there.
No,
I was scared.
I'm here now.
But I'm next to my big man.
You won that argument, definitely. Look, come on, you know what this world is like. Anything and everything can be a bar.
I could imagine a bar like that.
Yeah.
It is a sort of... You could imagine some prick...
You could, of course.
Some prick
sure
coming up with it.
Somewhere, yeah. That mean?
Or welcome to the cement mixer bar. Fuck
this is
you.
What I'm...
Fuck you, you hipster pricks.
Top idea.
Ardal, what was the blue stuff you sprayed in the client's hair afterwards?
That was... like one of those froobs.
Why did you put a froob in her hair? Is a question I never thought I'd ask anyone.
She wanted a colour, so I picked the nearest, like, colour that I thought she'd like.
Probably needs a little fine-tuning. I'm so sorry to bring the mood down, but we need to fuel this madness via consumerism now. That's the end of part one! Part two, and it's time for some more cement mixer action.
Yes, but that action cannot, under any circumstances, involve cement mixing. OK? I'm deadly serious, guys. And that's because the best use for a cement mixer, other than for mixing cement, wins the task. We've seen two people's attempts, and now we're going to see two other people's attempts. It's Bridget and Sophie.
Even though we've been working together for a certain amount of time, we don't really know or like each other very much. So I thought that a good way to counteract that, I've put together some icebreakers, and they're going to be mixed around by the cement mixer, and then we can find out a little bit more about you.
Right, shall I give it a mix?
Yeah.
On it goes.
Ah!
What are we doing to our planet? We've only got one. Stop ruining it.
Isn't that a horrible...
Come on.
Oh, OK, all right.
It's self-selected something.
Blue. It's a compliment.
You have kind eyes.
Thank you.
Right. Oh, I like this machine. Can we have another go?
Yeah.
OK.
Elon Musk, stop sending your cars and stuff up into space. It's not what space is for. Just keep them on your drive.
I've got a compliment, a question.
Ah, right. You smell familiar. Compliment?
Yeah, thank you, yeah. Which previous Taskmaster contestant would you raise as your own child?
Hugh Dennis.
Right.
And all the bottles in the seas and in all the fields and gardens. Stop it!
Why don't you believe in yourself?
Good news?
You're going to die sooner than you think.
Ah.
Yeah.
Well, I was thinking 2050.
No.
No,
you're going to be long dead before then.
I like the first couple.
Yeah.
OK.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Believe in yourself.
Shall I tell you what I saw? I saw a lunatic dressed as a cowboy playing one note on a violin. Talk me through the rhyming scheme.
Was there a rhyme?
Nope.
So she did try to use the cement mixer as a musical instrument and a metaphor.
I think you'll find that that's going to be a cult number one hit.
Oh, God.
I don't think you can have a cult number one hit.
And anyway, let's let you off the hook a bit. Yeah. I mean, what? Yours was just mad.
I just think there's not enough space for tenderness on this show.
Oh. You're going to die soon.
We're all going to die soon.
A weird collection. Which contestant would you make your child? Why don't you believe in yourself? It's just insane. I mean, it's not as insane as someone plucking on a violin and saying, stop it.
Who's left? There is just one little sausage left, and it's Christopher Ramsey.
Welcome to the sausage arena.
Thank you.
Your sausage is on the red stick and ribbon, my sausage is on the blue stick and ribbon, matching with the headbands that I've made. Now, the first person to swallow a piece of their sausage and only their sausage wins. Goggles on. You ready? Are you set?
I'm set.
Spin those sausages. Oh my God! Oh my God! I'm too scared!
Oh. Oh. Does it hurt?
No, it's okay. It's okay. It's so fast. It's so much faster than I thought it would be.
Very wrapped up. Oh. I'm not good. Why can't I get
it? I have swallowed some sausage.
I don't know anyone who wouldn't want to play sausage mixer.
It was like a roller coaster with sausages coming at you.
So funny. Like, rarely have I seen a sausage go from still to accelerating that fast.
Yeah, well, I've Googled it. I don't think anyone has ever done that before.
Of course they haven't. This is what I think I've got to do. I've got to draw a gulf between the greatest idea and the others.
Oh.
So I'm going to give Ardal and Sophie 1 point.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah? Because it's a very worthy cause and a powerful message. I'm going to give Bridget 2 points. I'm going to give Judi, because she's a great saleswoman, and I could imagine some bell end in East London doing that, 3 points. Then I'm leaving a gulf, and then I'm giving the sausage machine the 5 points it truly deserves.
Wow.
OK, thank you very much.
So, may we see a scoreboard, please?
Bridget is at the bottom of the leaderboard with 3. Chris is at the top with 9 points. Ooh. There it is.
Then let us have another one.
Yes, and there's something strange afoot in our little garden dome. Yes, Sophie.
Hey.
Hello.
You may enter the fun zone.
Ooh, thank you.
Very echoey.
Thank you. That's enough.
OK.
Key.
Record the highest number on this pedometer.
You have 20 minutes.
Your time starts now. I'm presuming this is the pedometer and not that.
OK, firstly, what is a pedometer?
So a pedometer counts your steps.
OK.
Do I have to do it in here?
All the information on the task, Chris.
You've not seen a pedometer before, no?
No.
No, I didn't. I never want to see one again.
You never heard of a pedometer?
No, I've got, like, the watch and stuff. I'm not used to the old techie stuff.
So you're not used to the old techie stuff and you're not used to the new techie stuff?
I get carried everywhere.
Let's crack on.
OK, well, it's a fairly classic Taskmaster task, I think. First up, it's the basic guys, Ardal and Chris.
So I need to find something that takes a lot of steps. I could put the pedometer on the foot-shaped thing.
OK.
Come on, man.
It is warm in here. Oh, it burns. Oh, my God. Oh, it's so hot.
I mean, I just can't wait to see the others. Like, they're just going to be running around like fools.
Oh, this is horrible.
Maybe I'll just pop out here.
It doesn't stay on there that I've got to stay in here. I can't stay in here. Oh, that way. I don't know why I did that.
No, that was your choice.
And if I do this, is that better?
Do you think you're taking more or fewer steps?
I'm going to check now.
OK.
Oh, that's quite good, like a yo-yo. That helps.
What's it on now?
It's 172. Is there a limit on this? It doesn't go beyond a certain number.
I think it'll go beyond 172.
Up to 200, possibly.
Come on!
Absolutely dripping.
Congratulations.
Oh! Oh, look at that!
I'm worried about your health.
Oh, thank you so much.
So hot. Chris, why did you commit to the system that you chose?
Walking around, I feel I would have been more tired. I think I would have had to be like sprinting on the spot, whereas I was only moving my hand.
Give me some stats for Chris's loose wrist system.
Well, the loose wrist system was very clever. He actually managed to do 2,789 steps in just 20 minutes, which is very impressive.
Wow.
It's about a mile and a third in 20 minutes.
Oh, Chris, you're getting on my nerves.
Ardal.
Yes.
Interesting decision to use a wooden foot, only in that you have a real foot.
I have a real foot. I mean, I didn't want to run around in the heat. I feel I've done the world a service by showing that you can get your steps in every day without actually having to move.
He was only on 172 after 10 minutes, but he sped up. He got to 1,084 steps. Respectable.
So he managed to get past the 200 limit.
Yeah.
We've seen a lot. Let's have a break. If your partner's fallen asleep and is snoring next to you, why not have a bit of fun and leave them? We'll see you after the break. Welcome back to Taskmaster. What was happening before the break, Alex?
There's a task in play in which they're trying to record the highest number on the pedometer provided. We've had the Route 1 masters, Ardal and Chris. Now for some alternative step-making with Judi and Sophie.
What can I strap this to? A bike. No, but then I've got to ride it.
Uh-huh. Do you have a yo-yo?
No.
Can I get a drill, please?
I'll get you a drill.
Not helping.
Oh.
A dog, can you get me a little puppy? Put it on the puppy, the puppy can run up and down.
I can get you a rat.
I don't want a rat. What kind of rat?
A remote control rat.
Yes!
This is so much better.
Just go round, just keep going round. Oh.
Wheels go up and down. Oh, that was so much cooler in my head.
10 seconds.
Wait! It's really Really hard task that was.
Yep. Thanks, Judy.
No!
Yeah.
I can't believe I've got 480-something.
Well, I'm amazed you got that many, to be honest. Because for the vast majority of it, you just put it on the back of a remote-controlled car, where it would have got no steps. Because it's a car!
I think that was a setup. It was Alex that told me, I've got your remote control.
Well, you kept asking for a dog and I offered you a rat.
So look what I was asking for, a dog that actually steps. Mm.
Another conspiracy theory. Sophie's ideas were a little more successful.
You saw from the prize task, I love power tools. I got a drill.
Did that drill work when yes. it was yes. it around? Did that add?
Yeah, she got into the thousands.
She got into thousands.
What did Judy get?
483. Sophie, 1,209. And she didn't expend as much energy as Chris. And she looked cool and powerful throughout. That's what she said.
Oh, that's what she said.
408. I am so pissed off.
You used a remote control rat.
One left, Greg.
One left, let's go.
Finally, it's Bridget, all by herself. Whoopsie. Oh, no.
It's not moving.
We haven't taken any steps.
I have, I just did some.
Do you think you're stepping?
I am stepping, look. Step, 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 step. That is a step.
You're not going very far forward.
I don't want to do this for 20 minutes.
Try going forward.
23.
You're keeping it very still.
What do you mean? What, I've got to move around like that?
No, I think you've just got to take...
It's still on 84.
But you haven't taken any normal steps.
Oh, my God.
That's it.
Oh, so what I'm going to do is record the biggest number that I know whilst on this pedometer. OK.
I'm looking forward to this number.
Are you writing it down?
I don't need to write it down.
OK.
Because you're recording it.
A trillion gazillion.
Have you thought of 2 trillion gazillions? Are you stopping there?
11 trillion gazillion.
OK.
How much longer is left?
You're not wearing it.
I don't need it because I've got the number.
OK, 139.
If you say it's 139, I don't mind, actually. I'm just really happy in life. I don't mind.
Thank you, Bridget.
It's not a question I expected to ask after this task, but have you ever walked?
If I walked normally, it wouldn't count.
That's because you were holding it. You were holding
it. What do you mean if you walked normally, it wouldn't
if
count?
If I just did that, it wouldn't...
How do you know? You didn't do that at any point. You just did this. At no point did you attempt to walk.
I did.
And you were getting exasperated with him. Oh, I suppose I should walk like this, then. Fascinating, Bridget.
Well, I did record the most amount of steps on a pedometer.
And it wasn't even about steps. The task itself was record the highest number on this pedometer. She was on the pedometer and she recorded 11 trillion gazillion.
It's a very high number.
11 trillion is a number. Gazillion... Not so much, but it is a high number.
And was she on a pedometer at the time?
Yes.
Oh, my God.
So, there's some quite contrasting numbers.
Yeah.
We go from Judy with 483, Ardal about 1,000, Sophie 1,200, Chris 2,789, Bridget's either 11 trillion gazillion or 139.
I mean, fair play. I think she has done it.
Oh, my God.
I think I'm going to have to allow it, and it's very clever lateral thinking. But I would remind you of how she walks day to day. It gives you a little lift.
I got beaten by someone recording a number.
Oh, you know you got beaten by everyone.
So it's 1 point to Judy, 2 to Ardal, 3 to Sophie, 4 to Chris, and 5 to Bridget Christie.
There it is! What is next, my furry chum?
Thank you. We have a task which involves all 40 contestants. Mm-hmm.
very comfortable.
Well, I don't feel very comfortable.
Hold a meeting with yourselves.
There must be 8 of you at the meeting.
Most dramatic meeting Mormon wins.
You have 20 minutes. Your time starts now.
Right, so 7 other me's.
What sort of meeting do you think you might do?
I think I'll have a meeting of the tennis club.
Are they quite dramatic?
This one's going to be very dramatic.
What I instantly thought of was, like, your death.
My death?
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Pretty straightforward. Some meetings with a dramatic moment in them.
Yes.
And one of them will result in your death.
Yes. Second time in the show.
Couldn't be happier. That's quite a nasty...
It wasn't because I, like, wanted him to die. I just thought what would be the saddest, most dramatic thing to happen to the show.
Okay, that's better.
Nah, just be collateral damage. Let's crack on.
OK, well, let's crack on with some Chris Ramsey's. This is his meeting moment.
So I'm sure you all know why we're here. Some chocolate has been stolen, and it was one of you greedy pricks. We're going to find out who. Well, I don't like to point fingers, and I don't agree with any of this, and I'm not going to rat anyone out. It's just not my style. Oh, if there was something in this, I'd throw it at you. Chris, you've been very quiet. What? What's all this? See? Mm. See? Have I got any chocolate on my face?
I'm not genuinely not sure what the dramatic moment was.
Ah, all of it.
There may not have been an especially dramatic moment in it, but there was some rather quality acting. Can you show the clip?
Yeah. OK, here's some acting from Chris.
Oh, God.
you've never met Carl, but that's bang on.
There was a start, there was a group of different characters. There was some of the greatest acting you'll see on a screen this year. So it wasn't a complete disaster. I can't say there was especially high drama.
Why is it still on?
Let's crack on. Who's next?
OK, the bar is set. We're now going to see a few Bridgets. Here we go.
Gluttonous. Yep. Guilty. Yep. Scared. Annoyingly self-deprecating. Overly sensitive. Vain. Shame. Great. Thanks for coming, guys. Very brave and honest of you. Good work. Gluttonous. Just have 2 biscuits and then put the packet back. Guilty. Catholic. I'm afraid I can't help you there. Scared. You know what? What's the worst that can happen? Just do it. Overly sensitive. You know what? Be sensitive. Just not overly. Annoyingly self-deprecating. You've got to stop this, because it annoys everybody. Some things you've done have been all right. Vain. You'd think now, by 50, you would have got on top of this. Just, that's, you can't change it now. Shame. But thanks for coming, everyone, though. Really, I don't want to get rid of any of you, because you make me. Just try and get on top of it a little bit.
It's certainly a very clever idea to look inwardly and to consider the many facets of your own character. The only dramatic moment in it, as far as I could work out, was when a bird flew past the camera.
I think what I did was I didn't... I should have overacted...
The mistake you made was that you didn't do the task.
Yeah.
Who's next?
Next, we're going to see the impressionist, Sophie Duca. Good luck, everyone.
Dog! Right, we all know why we're here. Because my worthless assistant, little Alex Horn, is dead.
Oh, no, I can't believe it.
Murdered. Yes, murdered. So who did it?
Babe, not me.
I definitely didn't do it.
Oh, all right, I killed your assistant. But only because he was so annoying.
Bridget, 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 you have killed the Taskmaster's assistant, and in so doing, you have proved yourself worthy to be the next Taskmaster's assistant. Take this clipboard and this pen and welcome to Taskmaster.
Some lovely character work, Chris Ramsey. Mm.
Nailed it.
Absolutely spot on. And the moment of high drama?
When Bridget caught the clipboard, an aerial passage of power to Taskmaster.
There was an aerial passage of power.
First place so far?
Oh, God, yeah.
OK, good stuff.
Don't worry, everybody. There's only one part left until somebody has to celebrate on stage with Ardal Hanlon's tea towel. Are you not entertained? See you after the break. For the final time this episode, before the break, our cast were all having meetings with themselves.
Yes, there had to be eight of themselves in the meeting, and the most dramatic meeting moment wins. We're off to the tennis club now with Ardal O'Hanlon.
OK, settle down. As chairman, I'd like to call this meeting to order.
Before we go any further, chairman, some gobshite's blocking the Bentley.
Oh, I'm so sorry. That's me. Excuse me. I just want to say, Chairman, the greens are in a terrible state.
I'm sorry. This is the tennis club.
Oh, tennis club.
I shouldn't be here. Silly me.
Well, good riddance. Your backhand was terrible. Well, Mr. Chairman, I think it's time I revealed my true identity. I'm an undercover police officer. And I'm arresting you for embezzlement and murder. More importantly, I'm resigning from the club.
Wow.
Dramatic.
Crazy drama.
Lots going on.
It seemed that embezzlement was a far bigger crime than murder. Embezzlement and murder.
Yeah. Extra drama, a little bit extra.
Who was the character that was crying?
That was the treasurer, because...
Pretty good.
Yeah, I was a golf player in the wrong club. I was excited by that.
Oh, my God.
Someone had to move the Bentley.
Doing the wrong sport?
Yeah.
I almost spat my tea. Who's next?
All right, there's only one left. Finally, it must be love. Here she is.
Some of us have joined this meeting because we've got a bit of an issue with Billy. Mrs. Mitchum, do you want to lead? I mean, Billy is an absolute twit. Excuse me, I'm not happy about you speaking about my husband like this. Oi, Siobhan! You're calling me a twit, but I bet you didn't tell him you're having my baby! I knew it, because I saw them the other day. Remember when I phoned you the other day? You're sitting there all quiet and recording, but I saw it the other day, and I was telling you that I saw him! And her! Billy, no!
Wow.
Bag of dramas.
Bags of drama.
Affairs, stealing people's men, gossiping.
Was there a troublesome child?
The troublesome child is in the belly. I mean, with that, you'd want to see what happens next, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
All right. Do you want to go from least dramatic to most dramatic?
I do. Sorry. Bridget, I really enjoyed your self-analysis, but there wasn't a lot of drama in it, so I can only give you 1 point.
OK.
Chris, that's one of the greatest acting performances I've ever seen in my life. You take that home with you tonight, plus 2 points.
2 points?
There was one moment of high drama in it, and I very much liked it, and I enjoyed the image of you being hurt.
Oh.
Sophie gets 3 points.
Sophie, 3? OK, so it's between Judi and Ardal.
Just because of the sheer stoking of hysteria that Judi pulled off, I think I'm going to give her the 5.
Judi, oh, win a task.
My God.
5 points to Judi.
Let's have a quick look at the scores.
Of course. Well, Ardal's now in second place with 12, but Chris is still in the lead with 15 points.
OK, everyone, please, for a change, stay where you are. for the final task of the show.
Ooh.
Who will read the task?
I've hidden the task under one of their chairs. Chris's chair. He's acting.
He's there. No, that's acting. That's acting.
Correctly guess this person's first name. You must ask a yes or a no question on your turn. If you take more than 10 seconds to ask your question, you miss a go. The person who guesses correctly wins 5 points.
Simple as that. So there's only one winner of this one. We're going to start with Ardal. Move down the line.
Rotate! Ardal, your 10-second start now.
Are you a French trapeze artist? No.
I mean, what sort of fucking opener was that? Bridget.
Is your name Andrew?
No.
God almighty. Chris, your turn.
Does your name begin with a vowel?
No.
Thanks, Chris. Judy.
Has one of the roles got your name?
No.
Damn it.
Sophie.
Is your name longer than 4 letters?
Yes.
Good question. Okay. Ardal.
Does your name begin with a letter that starts after K? Yes.
Bridget.
Is your name gender neutral?
No.
Chris.
Does your name begin with an S?
No.
Judy.
Is your name Pimpernickel?
No.
Your name more than 3 syllables?
No.
Ardal.
Does your name begin with any of the last 5 letters of the alphabet? No.
Oh.
Nah, nice.
Okay.
Good. Okay, we're making progress.
Bridget.
Is your name embarrassing?
No.
Chris.
Is your name Luigi?
No.
Judy.
Is your name Quantum?
She's pointing.
Is your name Quantum?
No.
Sophie?
Do you think it's likely there's someone else in this room with your name?
No.
For those of you wondering, the answer is, yep, we're staying here till we get it.
English?
Sports person.
Leonardo.
German.
Famous in the UK.
Xavier.
Barack.
Tiger.
Obama.
Double letters in it.
A verb.
Zebedee.
Begin with an O.
Shakespeare.
End with a vowel.
No. Is your name Maximus?
Vlad.
Ludwig.
German.
No, 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 no.
Listen, it's not up to me, but I would suggest it would be a good thing to do to find out which letter is name. Ardal.
Does your name begin with...
Oh, my God!
Sorry.
Hey, let's go again. Bridget.
M.
No.
Thank you.
L.
No.
N.
No.
Q.
Yes.
Now, listen, this is a genuine chance for Ardal here.
Is your name Quinny? No.
Doesn't...
Shit.
Bridget.
Quasimodo.
No.
Chris.
Qantas.
No.
Judy.
Quiz.
No.
It's not quiz.
And just by the way, this is the 75th question.
Sophie.
Is your name Quentin?
Yes.
So, 5 points, finally, to Sophie!
Thank you to Quentin. Your task is complete.
Goodbye!
How has that affected the final scores, Alex?
Well, that swift game of guess the name meant that Sophie leapt up in the places and she's now in joint first place with Chris Ramsey.
Exciting, then. A tiebreak.
It is a tiebreak. And for this one, they had to sing I've Won in a low voice and then this tiebreak in high voice. Greatest vocal range wins. Here's how they got on.
See, I'm a Geordie, so when I get angry, hi goes, hi, when I get angry. Okay.
Okay.
I want this tiebreak.
Chris.
Let's get that furball out eventually.
Yeah, just a...
Well, they both did very well. Chris went from an F2 to an F5. That's 21 notes. Sophie, from an A2 to an E6. As we all know, that's 25 notes! Oh.
Sophie Duker wins! Please head up to Cooley collect your carving item! So what have we learned today? We've learned you've got to look after yourself. Take care to look after you. Get out there. Exercise. Actually, that reminds me, I'm still 10 steps short of my target for today, so if you don't mind. And now for some celebrations with tonight's winner, Sophie Duker!